What's the family? Co-creators, producers, founders,
stars of the show.
Stars of the show.
Right.
They here.
They here.
We got the owners, operators,
the man behind
marketing plan.
The dudes that took the trademark storm.
The brand.
The country. The brand.
The brand.
Right. They really made a brand.
Everybody. Welcome to the show.
Yeah, let's do Will Money. Will Money. My man Tommy Walker.
What's your name,
brother? Will Willingham. What's your name, brother?
Tommy Walker.
Tommy Walker, I'd like to introduce you to the podcast.
The podcast
and her. Yes. THA.
Okay.
Now, what we do here at the podcast and her is we interview our culture. And today is a very exciting day for us because you guys are a brand that's within our culture. And what we like to do for our fans, per se, people that are watching, is give them information and how that they may be able to do possibly. I know some other t-shirt people. I know some other people that start business. I know y'all probably had some bows and foes. So we want to kind of get a little bit at that. And get to know you guys just a little bit as quickly as we can. I know y'all got stuff to do. So, that being said, go ahead and introduce yourself to the people.
I'm Tommy Walker, creator of Detroit vs. Everybody.
Yeah.
I'm Will William, the brand partner and brand management for Detroit vs. Everybody, the brand.
Now, how'd you guys get started?
Well, we started in 2012. In 2012, my other partner, Sean Williams, right here, Sean.
Yeah, come on in.
This is actually my best friend since kindergarten.
All right.
So, you know, we've always been trying to come up with entrepreneurial endeavors and things like that.
Right.
So we came up with, we purchased a failing screen printing company in 2012. And, you know, we were just working with other churches and schools, different organizations, just doing their t-shirts and learning the business at the same time.
Right.
And, you know, personally, I'm a graphic designer by trade. You know, I worked with Def Jam, Interscope, Jive. In college,
What college you go to?
I went to Wayne State University. I did 2 years at Wayne State.
Okay, so you from Detroit?
I'm from Detroit, born and bred. I went to Cass Tech.
Okay, not another Cass Tech.
Yeah, I'm saying Michigan.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Cass Tech is pushing out some good people.
Yeah, yeah. So
that's what's up.
So we purchased a failing screen printing company, learned the business, and then wanted to create a brand that embodied the energy of Detroit at the time.
Right.
You know, so at the time in 2012, we were coming off the downslope of the Kwame Kilpatrick situation.
Uh-huh.
And it was just a whole bunch of negative press about Detroit, but inside of Detroit, it was the resurgence that everybody's talking about now. It was the very beginning of that, you know what I'm saying? And you know, we had boots on the ground, in Detroit to see what really was going on. And we wanted to create a brand that spoke to that.
Man, when I tell you Detroit versus everybody, it's just that what you just said, it explains it all. And I felt what you just explained. You know, we were down, the market was down, cars weren't selling.
Like Detroit down.
Right.
Yeah, that's it.
And I remember when I seen the shirt. I'm sorry to cut you off. When I seen the shirt, the first one I said was Prince Fielder. I was like, yo,
wow,
they own something.
Yeah,
I called or texted or something like, yo, put the foot on their neck and just keep going. And I swear to God, y'all don't let go yet.
No, we're not.
So when did you feel like you had something?
Well, I mean, you know, let me talk about this. We registered at the same, around the same time. Before we even launched, we had the registration and everything.
Tell people what that too. What do you have to do to register a brand?
Well, it's different things. Like, you know, we did it ourselves.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We trademarked it ourselves.
Right.
But you can do that, do your due diligence, or you can just go hire a lawyer.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
And trademark whatever you think is important.
Yeah, that protection is necessary. That was. If we didn't do that, we wouldn't be here talking to you right now.
Wow.
Honestly.
I think that was the best movie I made. When I seen it, I was like.
So trademark people.
Trademark everything. Trademark every idea.
Yes. I heard Beyonce trademark their kids' names. That's important information. That's what I'm talking about. So I'm going to move on to my next one. Go ahead, man.
I was part of the show with the Hip Hop Brothers. Y'all don't know what y'all done worked with Puff. How easy was it to work with these people? Or did they come to y'all, or did y'all go seeking them? You know what I mean? Or did y'all just keep y'all head down and keep focusing and let the people come to y'all?
A lot of it is organic, but a lot of it is relationships. You know what I'm saying? We've been blessed to have a great brand manager. You know what I mean? That pretty much makes anything happen. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all got the plug. Y'all plugged in.
You know what I'm saying? So, it just everything just snowballs, you know. But
is it somebody you want to work with?
We have honestly reached. There are people that you want to work with.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
You want? They might be listening. Hold on. Let me ask you this question. What have y'all had to say no to? Has some deal come across the table y'all can't believe y'all said no to it? You know what I mean? Like a licensing deal to somebody coming to y'all like.
Due to like red tape and like different like exclusivity situations and things like that, but nothing that's hurt us.
You know what I say no to the most is charges. Everybody versus everybody, my family versus everybody, you know, I know they got me throwing ideas off barbershop. Right. Or something like that. My barbershop versus everybody. I got a brilliant idea. It's just little stuff like that. But as far as the big plays or something that we think would be lucrative, not like something that'll be like wholesome substance or whatever, like we be on it, bro. We never back down to no challenge from the day one. Like even coming in, like one of our first challenges was getting every player on the lanes their size, and they wanted them in the locker room in like X amount of hours. You know what I'm saying? And then Shady Records, they wanted a certain amount of shirts, and they was trying to challenge us. You know what I'm saying? Like, can y'all get us 550 shirts in 48 hours? Just like that. Well, these guys, like, that's why it's so easy to make the job easy. Because they want their sleeves up, bro. They'll be up for 3 days. And, like, that's what I'm saying about the company. They don't ask nobody to do nothing.
And me either, so it's like, and me either, so I know they're where they're sleeved up, I know we're back our backs against the wall at any given time of the race. Yes, and I want to thank you guys because you're an awesome representation of us in business, and you guys are doing all, how many stores do you have? It's our fourth store. Made, this is a beautiful store, first of all, and one of the biggest malls in Michigan, and Detroit, closest one to Detroit that we got. You guys, awesome representation, man. You guys, I want you to keep doing what you do. What do you see on the horizon?
Well, you know, we like to keep a lot of our moves low.
Okay, so that's another tidbit.
Game to be sold.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
amen.
You know, but I'm very glad to get through. I'm very glad to get through this opening right now. You know? And I'm really, really excited to ride this out and see where this, what doors this opens up and see where this takes us. Right. But I can let you guys know that we do have a Versus Everybody website.
Okay. How can the people?
But you can check us out now at DetroitVersusEverybody.com.
Okay.
But within the next few weeks, we're gonna be changing it to Versus Everybody. Mm-hmm. And focusing to Versus Everybody.
So y'all growing.
Yeah.
Man,
we're not gonna stop.
I love it. I love it.
Thanks, Doc.
You got something else?
Man. I know, man. Let me do this. Every episode that I end up running into a dude that affect me a little bit, I give him something, you know. So, 1 minute. Excuse me.
What do you think?
Bro. Man, you, 91, y'all saved my life. You know what I'm saying? Like, I told Chris Henderson, we went to London, I talked to Chris. I told him, man, I showed up with dirt on me, unfocused. And I was on camera. I was thinking about going to, I was just out of high school. I was on going, me and my boys were going to rent a house and we were going to sell drugs. So I go over to Cuz's house, a real house. We sitting in the basement. I told him the idea. He laughed at me so hard. Man, that's dumb as hell, basically. He laughed at me so hard, but it made me feel bad, so it just gave me something to think about. So I walked away like, nah, that ain't gonna work. So then I watched everybody go through, like, man, I gotta get my shit together. They gonna pass me. I ain't gonna be able to have nobody to hang out with. So I've been watching, and I appreciate it. Man, because I swear, I'm fucked up as well. The whole circle, you know what I mean? And I know y'all, man. Man, no man, matter podcast, it, man. Totally. We appreciate this shit.
Yes.
From the heart, man. Facebook friends.
Yes. God.
God bless you, man.
That's just an awesome job.
Thank you.
We're not
going
to stop.
You want to tell the people where all the stores are?
Okay, so you got our flagship.
Yes, yes.
Our flagship is at Greektown in the 400 Monroe building. And then you can hop from there to Eastern Market, right on Russell, 2501 Russell, right in between Germack and Rocky's Peanuts. And then you can go to Southfield Road and 12 Mile. And right between the, we're between the AutoZone and the Applebee's.
Right.
And now, you got this location. And you can also check us out at DetroitVersusEverybody.com.
Right. Amen.
Yeah.
Well, guys, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I know y'all got a store to launch. Launch some more. I'm sure we'll see y'all in different states. That's what I'm looking
for.
I want to see Detroit versus everybody everywhere.
That's
so congratulations.
Thank you, man.
Thank you again. Give out the website. We gave that out.
We good.
It's a wrap.
Definitely.
Thank you, gentlemen. It's a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you.
Inspiration.
Appreciate
yes,
it. All love, man. All love, man. Definitely.
Podcast, man. We did it again.
Two dudes,
one from Pierce and one from Finko.
He was about to start crying.
Yo, I still got it because I keep telling every time I had to tell these stories because, man, I almost wasn't here. Peace.
Love y'all.